Hey guys, this is Rich from RICHTVLIVE, and Aurora Cannabis has some news that is breaking today. Aurora Cannabis announces key changes to its board of directors. This is news that is breaking today from Edmonton, where they're located. Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. Aurora Cannabis Inc. on the New York Stock Exchange and the TSX under the symbol ACB, and Frankfurt, Germany under the symbol A1C4WM, announced today that Michael Singer, previously chairman of the board, has been appointed executive chairman of the board of directors. The company also announced that independent director Ronald Funk has been named lead independent director, and Margaret, Shan, Atkins has been appointed as a new independent director and chair of the Audit Committee. Diane Jang, who served on the company's board since November 2017, has voluntarily resigned her position as director of Aurora. Here is the breakdown. As Aurora continues to mature into one of the world's largest and leading cannabis companies, it is important that our board continues to examine its composition to ensure that its experience and expertise aligns with the company's strategic direction, said Michael Singer, executive chairman. The changes announced today ensure that our board is well equipped to continue to provide that guidance and strong oversight to the company. In my new role, I will continue to work closely with the CEO, Terry Booth, and the rest of our senior executive team on all matters pertaining to strategic direction, execution, and finance. Ron, with his exceptional senior leadership track record and experience, has been a valuable contributor as an independent director and is now positioned to play a more critical role as our lead independent director. He will work closely with Norma Beauchamp, chair of the governance committee, to continue to advance and further enhance our corporate governance practices. Appointment of Shan Atkins. The company also appointed Shan Atkins as a new independent director and chair of the audit committee. Mr. Atkins brings deep experience in public company governance and leadership in global retail and healthcare companies such as Shoppers Drug Mart, Tim Hortons, and Sears, Roebuck and Company. Her expertise in overseeing public company reporting for both large Canadian and U.S. listed companies will prove an important asset for Aurora, which is dual listed on the TSX and the New York Stock Exchange. Ronald Funk, lead independent director, added, "Shan's expertise on the boards of both Canadian and U.S. public companies further strengthens the governance function at Aurora. Additionally, her track record in industry verticals with great relevance to Aurora provides tremendous value as the company develops, and we look forward to welcoming her on the board as an independent member and head of our audit committee." Shan Atkins. Miss Atkins brings over 20 years of corporate leadership of experience to Aurora. A certified public accountant, she spent 14 years at Bain & Company, where she became a partner and leader in the firm's global consumer and retail practice. She also maintained a secondary practice in healthcare, working in RX and OTC pharmaceuticals and in the hospitality industry. Ms. Atkins also served as executive VP of Sears, Roebuck & Company, USA, and since 1999, she has served as an independent director on 10 public and private corporate boards in the U.S. and Canada. She is currently on the boards of Darden, New York Stock Exchange, DRI, Spartan, Nash, NASD, SPTN, Sunopta, NASD, STLKL, TSX, SOY, and LSC Communications, LKSD on the New York Stock Exchange. Previously, Ms. Atkins served on the boards of Shoppers Drug Mart, Tim Hortons, and the Pep Boys. She is a graduate of Queen's University and the Harvard School of Business. Resignation of Diane Jang. Diane Jang, CEO of Hempco Food and Fiber. Hempco has voluntarily resigned from her position as Aurora's board of directors. Ms. Jang was appointed to the company's board in November 2017 and made important contributions in the development of the company's hemp strategy. Mr. Singer added, "We wish to thank Diane for her important contributions toward establishing Aurora's strong position in the domestic and international hemp business. which will remain her focus going forward as CEO of Hempco, in which we have a controlling ownership interest. Options and DSU grant. The company has awarded a director of the company 28,000 options pursuant to the company's stock option plan, exercisable at a price of $9.43 per common share. The options shall vest over a period of 3 years in equal annual installments. Additionally, the company has granted 5,000 deferred share units, vesting over 12 months in equal quarterly installments. About Aurora, headquartered in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, with funded capacity in excess of 500,000 kgs per annum and sales and operations in 23 countries across five continents, Aurora is one of the world's largest and leading cannabis companies. Aurora is vertically integrated and horizontally diversified across every key segment of the value chain, from facility engineering and design to cannabis breeding and genetics research, cannabis and hemp production, derivatives, high value add product development, home cultivation, wholesale, and retail distribution. Highly differentiated from its peers, Aurora has established a uniquely advanced, consistent, and efficient production strategy based on purpose-built facilities that integrate leading-edge technologies across all processes, defined by extensive automation and customization, resulting in the massive scale production of high-quality product at low cost. Intended to be replicable and scalable globally, our production facilities are designed to produce cannabis at significant scale with high quality, industry leading yields and low per gram production costs. Each of Aurora's facilities is built to meet EU GMP standards, and its first production facility, the recent required MedReleaf Markham facility, and its wholly owned European medical cannabis distributor, Aurora Deutschland, have achieved this level of certification. In addition to the company's rapid growth and strong execution on strategic M&A, which to date includes 15 wholly owned subsidiary companies, MedReleaf, Canvas RX, Peloton Pharmaceutical, Aurora Deutschland, H2 Biopharma, Urban Cultivator, BC Northern Lights, Larson Greenhouses, Canamed Therapeutics, Anandia Labs, Hot House Consulting, Med Columbia, AgroPro, Borella, and ICC Labs, Aurora is distinguished by its reputation as a partner and employer of choice in the global cannabis sector, having invested in and established strategic partnerships with a range of leading innovators, including Radiant Technologies, Inc., RTI on the TSX Venture, Hempco Food and Fiber, Inc., HEMP, Can Group Limited, CAN in the Australian Exchange, Micron Waste Technologies, MWM, Chum Holdings, CHOO, Capsium, which is a private company, Evio Beauty Group, private company, Wagner Dimas Private, CTT Pharmaceuticals, CTTH on the OTCC, and Alcana Inc., CLIQ. What do you think about this news? Now remember, Rich TV Live is strictly for education and entertainment purposes. Always do your due diligence, always do your research before you invest in anything that we talk about here on Rich TV Live. Aurora has always been one of my top picks. They continue to make moves. What do you think about this news? What do you think about these moves? Do you think that this makes a difference? Do you think this helps the company? Do you think this hurts the company? Love to know what you guys think. Comment down below, smash the like button, share the video everywhere. Aurora Cannabis announces key changes to its board of directors. It's true. And you heard it here first from your boy, Rich. If you're not winning, you're probably not watching. We bring you the winners. We bring them to you first. We give you instant analysis. We give you full alerts. And we love to bring you the news from Aurora Cannabis. Holler at your boy, www.richtvlive.com. Everywhere. It's true. Aurora Cannabis, back in the news. And I'm out. Peace.